I want to talk about an important topic today, and those are the pot fillers of our community. And the reason why I want to talk about them is because they are the lifeblood of our community. Fundamentally, we really have to rely on the venue fees and the people attending events to keep ourselves sustainable as a community. How do we provide value for these new players who go to these major tournaments, pay $500, and then go 1-2 or 0-2 and really just play for 1 hour out of the entire weekend?
All right, day one. About to play some melee.
Dude, watch out.
What?
Can I get some chocolate milk first?
Dude, hop off. Wait, where's your controller?
Oh, shit. Good. I'll just use the extra one.
Okay. I remember the first time I ever saw melee. It was at my friend's birthday party. I was probably in first, second, third grade. And I was just like, wow, this looks so much fun. Like, can I get in? They're just like, no, you have to wait your turn. You have to wait your turn. And like, the people who were playing never really got off. They just kept playing. We were watching. It was fine. Like, it was chill. Like, I was having fun watching.
I actually never really played melee as a kid. I didn't have a GameCube or anything, and I know that like everyone does. That's like a classic like childhood thing, is playing melee. But I was actually first introduced by a good friend of mine, and he showed it to me because like over the summer we were hanging out. I kind of like started. It was fun. I got destroyed like every time, but I was kind of come and hang out with him and play.
I eventually like played like a couple times as a kid, but I knew what melee was, but I really only like got into playing Smash like when we got a Wii for a Christmas present, and I eventually got to convince my parents, probably when I was in like fourth or fifth grade, convince my parents to let me get Brawl.
First got the sense that I like wanted to practice when I would play him. Like initially it was like always just like a fun thing. Like he'd played for longer than I had, and he like actually like had the game at home than I didn't. He had like his own controller and stuff, and he was like a lot more serious. But I would just play him. Like the more I played him, like even though I was never like trying, like I never like wanted to like win intensely. Like you get competitive about that kind of stuff. You know what I mean? It's like you want to get better.
Eventually, like found melee matches on YouTube, and I just like had like some reminiscent nostalgic memories of like seeing melee and like always really wanted to play it, and so just like. Like, I bought a GameCube from, like, DK Oldies or something and used the third-party controllers I had and got a Melee disc, and I don't know, I just started playing it.
I started watching, like, more documentaries about it. I started watching, like, games, like, competitive games, and I started to realize that, like, okay, like, I actually need to, like, start trying to, like, get good at this if I want to actually get better. Like, it's not a thing that's just going to happen naturally. You know what I mean? You have to, like, put in those out. Like, it's going to, like... And when I did, like, when I bought my own setup and started, like, actually practicing, like, you see it quickly. Super Smash Bros. Melee is a console game for the Nintendo GameCube that was released in 2001. It pits a range of characters from Nintendo franchises against each other, from iconic heroes like Mario or Link, to lesser known ones such as the Ice Climbers or Captain Falcon. In total, there are 26 characters to choose from. Clyde plays Sheik and Eamonn plays Falco.
Each of you has a certain number of lives, which are called stocks. It's typical to play with like four stocks. You pick a character, and then you try to basically knock each other off of the stage. And when you do, you end up losing a stock, and then the last person with any stocks remaining is the winner. You don't have like health. What you have is something called a percentage. So you gain, like, you put percentage on other people by like hitting them with smash attacks or just like special attacks and stuff along those lines. And what that does, the percentage in themselves, like in itself, is not what causes you to fall off the stage or get KO'd. What it does is it affects the amount of knockback you get. So like the higher percentage, the next time they hit you, the farther you'll go off the stage, which means consequently you're more likely to lose a stock or something along those lines.
In a competitive melee match, two players fight against each other with their respective characters on any one of the six legal tournament stages.
It started as fun, and then you realize, wait, there's actually a competitive scene. There's a lot more depth than there was in 2002 when I played.
Finding out how competitive the game was really eye-opening. So this is a game like I had always enjoyed and always wanted to be the best.
Most of the things that we use to advance the game, wave dashing, shield dropping, SDI, DI, V-canceling even, all these advanced techniques, right? They're in the game, but they're not introduced to you in the game manual.
The more people got into it, the more people like played on their own and started to discover these different things, these different parts about it. They discovered DI, which makes you like change the direction you're hit into when you're hit. They figured out all these like small techniques that make the game a lot more intense.
I really like the technical aspect of the game, just that, like, I've always been interested in that kind of stuff, just how precise, you know, the human hands and mind can be. I just like seeing myself improve in that aspect, but also in the kind of mental aspect of the game.
It was always fun to have this like 1v1 aspect of like reading people, because since I also fence, like having to like, you know, seeing what other people do and acting upon it, or like knowing what they're gonna do and acting in certain ways because of that.
There are like thousands of different approaches you can do, certain matchups between characters. Like, there's also the idea of like reading what your opponent's gonna do next. There might be like an optimal move or something, but that doesn't necessarily work because they could expect you to do that.
Despite all of that depth and complexity, there's just some nostalgic magic about the game that just makes it just so unbelievably fun.
It's just like there's some ethereal, supernatural side to Melee that just can't be explained. And anybody that's been in this scene for long enough, even new players, will tell you that there's just some unexplainable factor that keeps people going.
I mean, along with making new friends and knowing, I guess, other parts of like other people's lives and getting to connect with them, it was also really interesting watching the pro scene, which was actually really fun, rooting, you know, for your favorite people, or like seeing some of the amazing things that they do in Melee.
Crowd cheering for a four star. This could be it. This is it.
I'm pretty sure.
Oh, and that side. Ledge Castle turn around, grab. Wiz Boss is absolutely going off right now. Stop, Wiz Boss, calm down. Oh, the shine
of Armada. No, but wait a minute. That's it. He just comes down from the platform and gets a grab on the top. Top platform.
Wait, oh,
they're
my
freaking
God.
Out.
I'm freaking out, dude.
My name is Clyde Schwab.
My name is Eamonn Keenan.
And my smash tag is Fat Roscoe.
And my smash tag is Gudino.
So about a year ago, I started playing Toontown again, that game that everyone played as a little kid. My friend started playing, and so I started, and I got, for the random name generator, for my like big fat purple horse, I got Fat Roscoe, and I just kind of knew it was meant to be.
I was going on this page called collegeswimming.com, and I see this man who has a page, and his name is Manuel Gudino, and he had a very interesting page. Normally, like when you on collegeswimming.com, you have like your times inputted for like recognized like legitimate meets, and that's how you, then you get a ranking in your state and then the nation and stuff like that for your class. But this guy like put like a bunch of his like best times, like the fastest times he ever swam, to improve his ranking, and instead they did them like in practice. And I just thought that this guy's a legend.
So what are you gonna be doing tonight?
Tonight, I will be going to Rider Pie number 5, which is one of the Chicago weeklies. And it's in Wicker Park at a pizza shop.
I'm not sure how many people are going. I think probably like 20, 25, 30, I don't know. And I'm just gonna go there, enter into singles, and compete.
So this is gonna be like my fourth or fifth tournament.
I've only been to like, four tournaments previous to this.
I guess my goal for this tournament is to use this to establish as a baseline for the rest of the month, for the rest of the tournaments that I'll be attending to, just kind of see where I am, and then decide like, okay, like what do I need to practice, what I need to work on to improve on that placement. And definitely I want to improve on this placement no matter what.
I want to push myself a little bit. And part of that is I've always kind of like made stupid mistakes where like I know I probably could have done a lot better in a game, but I screw up. And like I want to try to, and like last time I went to a tournament, which was earlier this week, that happened a lot less, but it still happens. So I want to keep on working on not flubbing, like not kind of getting nerves, mom's spaghetti. And I'd say that's my goal. It's just to like have a good time. I want to see if I can take a game. But the thing is that like, you don't know who you're going to play. You could like happen to play someone who's just been playing the game for 10 years and is going to destroy you. And there's just no way you can win.
So you basically go in, it's pretty relaxed almost at every tournament I've been to. You just talk to the TO, the tournament organizer, and tell them your tag. You pay the fee if there is one, and then they tell you who you're going to play. And it's double elimination, so if you lose twice, that means you're out.
Every time, you lose a best of three, right? You get to go into losers and then try her again.
Hey Clyde, how do you think that went?
I'll take it.
I played my friend Fred, who just happened to like be coming to the tournament with us.
How do you think that went?
Yeah, rough though.
Hey, you play well.
And they were really close games. He plays Samus, and he's gotten really good really quickly. Then the next game I played was, I don't remember the guy's tag, but like he played Fox and Marth, and he like it was like not even, it was just kind of ridiculous. You know what I mean?
How did that game go?
Last game I played, like, I don't know. This guy just, like, it was talkative, and he just, like kept sort of hopping over here. I didn't know I beat him, but, like, he just didn't have section. Like, he just wasn't very good.
Overall, I'm pretty happy with it. I won a game, but I wouldn't say it's the most legitimate win because he was much under my skill level. But definitely a good place to be, I think, for me. I'm satisfied with it for now.
How do you think you're going to do the next tournament?
I don't know. Next tournament's tomorrow. It's another UChicago weekly. And it's hard to say. It really depends on who I play. But I feel like a lot more ready to like kind of do it. You know what I mean?
I definitely feel more confident generally, and I think that should set me up well, and I think the next tournament I'll be able to hopefully expand upon that newfound confidence and perform better.
All right.
Singles is really frustrating. It was kind of disappointing. I felt like after Ryder Pi that I had a lot of newfound confidence and I was ready to play well and win games. And I lost both my games, winners round one and losers round one. I got 2-0 both times.
First round, I think I played this really good Dr. Mario, got 2-0'd, went to losers, played this guy who plays Puff and Captain Falcon, and got 2-0'd again.
I was really disappointed. I want more. It's motivating. I know that I need to work more and learn how to be more confident, and I want to go to the next tournament now because I want to do better.
You ready for this tournament?
Mess up this tournament.
What'd you say?
Mess this tournament up.
Alrighty.
You shouldn't be letting me go to game five every time this ice tournament.
He was a really good Fox player, but I'm kind of disappointed by that. I thought that I would do pretty well. My practice has made a little bit of difference. I think that I still need to overcome like tournament nerve stuff and stuff like that. So hopefully I can bring it for the next games I play.
Then the next game, it was for some Ganondorf player, and I lost the first match. And then I, you know, was a little bit down, but like I just heard Clyde in the background saying, like, let's go, Eamonn, like, you got this. And I was like, okay, like, I can come back from this.
I played this Ganondorf and Fox player who didn't really know what he's doing. He clearly hadn't played for a long time. I beat him 2-0, which felt really nice. Gave me a good amount of confidence going to my next match, which was against Ro, who's ranked number one in Chicago. Actually, I got to play him on stream. The first match went pretty well, actually. And the second match, he... Then after that, I played this guy who's a pretty well-known Project M, which is another Smash game player, and he beat me the first game, took the second game, and then he beat me. He was close, but he beat me the third game.
And then I played Windy, who was a guy that Clyde played at the first round that we went to, Ryder Pi. And he's just like really good, like seed really high. I'm pretty sure he's taken games, or at least been really close to taking games off of players on the PR in Chicago. You know, I knew he was good. I played in friendlies, and like I just kind of went into the match just do crazy stuff and have fun, like just get used to doing stuff like that. And the first game, it went down to last stock, and he had me at like really high percent, and he was at like a sub 50% or something like that. And I was just thinking in my head, like, if I had to take this game, like, I had to do something crazy. And like I just got off stage and just suicide off stage and tried to take him with me, and luckily he died first, and so I won the first game. And then he brought it back 2-1, which, you know, I expected, but like, I just remember when I killed him in that first game, like, people were watching, and background, they were just like, oh my god, that was crazy.
Like, you just talk about a little bit how your performance, what you're happy about, what you're satisfied about.
Well, I'm happy with my first game, my first set. That felt good, even though the guy wasn't super experienced. I played, I think, pretty well. Played a lot of confidence, and that gave me a lot of confidence playing against that game with Ro. And even though he clearly wasn't trying super hard, like he wasn't going 100%, it still felt good to bring him down to last stock and kind of make him try for the next game. I felt like I held my own in a way that he really wasn't expecting. That made me feel pretty good.
The tournament was awesome. It was, for me, kind of like the definition of a comeback. I told one of the tournament organizers like what the score was, and I was like, it was 2-1 versus Windy, and he was like, all right, I have to seed you higher next time. And I was just like, all right, I'm making progress, like this is actually going somewhere.
Clyde, what are you gonna do with this tournament?
Mess him up.
What are you gonna do?
Mess him up.
Gonna mess the tournament up?
How was your dinner?
Do you feel ready?
I feel very ready.
Would just sit down at my setup and just play for honestly like hours on end.
Practicing like different advanced techniques and various different movements in the game over and over and over.
Practicing the same exact button input for, you know, like 30 minutes at a time and then moving on to some other tech skill.
Making sure that when I want to do those in tournament, those are rock solid, I'm not going to mess them up.
I was literally doing things I've never done before in tournament and some things that I don't even do in friendlies that often. Like I got like a perfect ledge desk and I'm just like, how am I doing this? Like I had no idea that I could do this in tournament, and it just showed that like all the practice that I'm doing is like maybe not necessarily translating to concrete wins, but I'm doing better. I'm playing better.
I was tech chasing in a way I never had before. I wasn't screwing up my movement. I was controlling my character exactly how I wanted to. It makes me feel like I can compete in a way that I haven't really felt confident that I could before.
Can you explain like what just happened?
All right, so
like the risk that we took.
We're gonna go to a tournament in Wicker Park today, Rider Pie. I was mentioning before, but it turns out that is next week on Monday, so a little bit late. So instead, we are going to Geneva, Illinois, which is about an hour and a half away, to go to the Gaming Goat Weekly. And we did not actually know whether or not it existed when we started this Uber trip, and recently found out to our luck that it did.
I think it's addicting just because you can see yourself improve so much.
I was playing better and I was still playing against people who were much better than me. And I was doing things that showed that I could compete with them.
Your goal should be to play well, right? Not your goal should never be to win.
It doesn't matter how young you are or anything about who you are, but when you become the player, your results and your merit really dictate like how players perceive you.
I see what they're doing. I can outplay a lot of these people. And like when I like put in the hours, like I feel like I can do it.
But at the same time, like, I didn't get the results that I would hope for.
If this was your last tournament,
yeah.
Would you be satisfied with this?
Yes and no. And that I would be satisfied that I think that I played well. There's some things I want to fix, but I think I played well. No, in the sense that I don't want to stop. I'm not like, okay, I had my fill. This whole period of time has just made me realize how much better I can get.
I think overall, this tournament, I'm dissatisfied with where I stand, but happy with where I've come from.
For a lot of people, I'm sure it's about being a platform for like self-improvement in a way. Because you like to be able to see that you can take something you're bad at, because everyone's bad when they start. And you like being able to see that you can take something you're bad at and just become better just through work.
While Smash is a very competitive game, and while it might be very daunting for some people to get into the Smash scene, we all start somewhere. And even the very best started at a small stage. They were just kids. They're just playing with this random, what was known as a party game. And they got good. They dedicated their lives for it. And while a lot of the people who might, you know, be watching this is not gonna have that same kind of dedication, I think you should not be intimidated by like the general high skill level. and just to find maybe a group of friends or just enjoy the game. Because in the end, this is for enjoyment, not for pure needing to be, I must win.
I wouldn't play any other game. Because in bracket, in person, you see what people are really like. You get to really like put yourself out there and have fun and joke around with people in person.
The game might seem distant to some players, but the community is always there.
Everyone seems really nice. Everyone's willing to help someone new get into the game.
Everyone I've talked to has just been literally like one of the nicest people like I've ever met. And they're all so welcoming. And I feel privileged to be able to interact with them in this community because just, it's really the best. I think that just goes to show that there are so many like arbitrary things that people can, that people will pursue or that seem so arbitrary, but once you immerse yourself in it, you realize like how meaningful it is to so many people and how important it is.
I think it's so cool that you can go to these like random places in Chicago and once a couple times a week, there's this group of, like 20 or 30 people who are just really into this game that came out like 15 years ago and play and like get really, and like they're all nice, like they're all gonna talk to you. And I just think that that's like, it's like this little like micro community, this little like niche thing that's awesome. And so I kind of like, I think I wanna show people that.